Hey there, Power Platform enthusiasts. Stefan Superfloof here. Welcome back to another exciting episode of our Power Apps 101 series. Today, Superfloof and I will be your guides as we continue our journey of creating Power Apps one step at a time from start to finish. In this episode, we're tackling a very important part of app development, managing user permissions to tailor content within our Power App. Now, I know permissions may not sound like the most thrilling thing, but trust me, it's an absolute necessity when it comes to app development. Whether you're working with a small team or a large company, controlling who sees what is obviously pretty important. In this video, we'll explore how to leverage a SharePoint list of administrators to dynamically show or hide content within the Power App based on the user's permission. We could also leverage information within an Active Directory group, let's say a department, or Dataverse. This use case is just one of many options. Superfloof and I will walk you through the whole process, so don't worry if you're new to this. By the end of it, you're going to be a permission pro and your apps will be more secure and user-friendly than ever. So grab your favorite snack and let's get started. But first, if you're enjoying this series, please make sure to hit that subscribe button and join our community for more Power Platform tips and tricks. Let's get started. Let's start with the finished product first. From our previous video, we have our modern responsive app that has a welcome message to the end user saying either good morning or good afternoon. Now I've added a hamburger menu in the top left corner. It's called a hamburger menu because it looks like a hamburger, McDonald's hamburger, that takes us to a screen showing expense reports. This hamburger menu shows if the user that is currently viewing the app is in this SharePoint list and is marked as active, which my account currently is. Let's build this together. Here we are in make.powerapps.com in my welcome app. The first thing that we need to do is add the data connection to this SharePoint list. So from our hamburger menu, we select data and we're going to add data. Enter SharePoint, select our connector, which is your account. We're going to select the site that owns the list and then the list itself and hit connect. Now that we have the data connection, we need to add in the icon that'll do something for us. So we're gonna go to input or insert and type in hamburger. And there we have the hamburger menu. I can click and drag and drop it right onto the responsive container. And because the responsive container is set to default one way or t'other, it added it to the end, which is not where we want it. So we're gonna right click, reorder, move to start. Now that we have the data connector and the menu, we need to figure out the logic to tell if the user that's logged in and looking at this app has rights to see that icon. So the first thing that we need to do is capture the user. Then we're going to compare the user information to the SharePoint list. And then we're going to use that to either hide or show the menu. So the first thing that we're going to do is click on app and select formulas from the dropdown. And then I'm going to expand this out to give myself a little bit more working room. I always start my code with comments because I don't want my coworkers to hate me. So we're going to get user data. Now in formulas, it has a little bit of a different format. So I'll show you this and then I'll show you start on start's formula method as well. So we're going to call this var user, and I cannot type if people are watching. So var user equals the current user that's logged in. Now I'm going to show you how to write the same bit of code, but using the onStart method. So we go back down to the dropdown and we're going to go to onStart and we're going to comment get user data. And this time I'm going to call it something else so it doesn't scream at me. Set var user to user. And there we have it. So now if I go back to app, right click, run onStart. So that kicks off the functionality. I double click on var user, I expand here. It shows me everything about the current user that's logged in. Full name, email, my image. If we go to formulas, double click on var user, we don't have the same functionality. So you're gonna have to figure out which one you like to use a little bit better. Okay, so now that we have the user's information, now we have to compare it to the admin list and see if this user is valid or not. So first thing that I like to do is I don't want to pull in all the information. Let's go back to the onStart and I'll show you what I'm talking about here. Give myself some room and I'm going to get admins. Now, if I create a collection, and the vernacular for that is Clear Connect, you see how IntelliSense is helping me finish my code. Now that it's finished it for me, I can hit Tab. So I'm gonna Clear Collect. What am I gonna call this? I'm gonna call it Call for Collection Approvers, because that's what makes sense to me. Use whatever vernacular you like, but be consistent with it. You'll thank me later, plus your coworkers won't hate you. And what are we putting into that collection? If I pull in everything from the SharePoint site admins, and I just close this out, I right click on app and run on start. And now if I double click on the name of the collection, I can preview everything that that's pulling in. It's pulling in two records with all of this extraneous data. If we scroll to the right, we'll see title, the two records, Steph and Baron. I don't wanna pull in all of that. So I'm gonna hit format data, and that makes everything nice and neat for me. So what I wanna do with this collection is I only wanna show certain columns, right? So I'm going to add the vernacular show columns. And what am I gonna do here? In the call admins, I only wanna show the column admin and the column active. Now, if I close out the paren, format the text again, right click, run on start, and preview the collection. There you see it's only pulling in admin, which is a record, which is the entire user's record, and whether or not that's true or false. Let me show you something that's also nice, is I can come over here to collections, see my same collection, and on the three ellipses, let me minimize this, three ellipses, view table. If you have bigger data sets and you want to drill into it, this is a really good way of using it. Once I clicked on the user, you'll see here how it's pulling everything in. Now, that might be great for your use case, but here I don't need all that information, right? I only need a subset of this. So what I'm going to do on top of the show columns is I'm going to add column. And what I'm going to do there is I'm going to, outside of the show columns, hit a comma, I'm going to add a column for email. And what do I want that column to be? I want that column to be admin.email. And you see how it pulled in everything from the record. And then I'm going to close out my paren. I'm going to right click on app, run on start, double click on my collection name, expand it out. And now we have active, admin, and email. I can visually see what I'm going to be comparing against. Now, with that information, I can create a variable called isAdmin and leverage what I have, and it's a true or false. I don't have to do if any statements or if then statements, any of that. It's just a true or false variable. Now let's set a variable to true or false if the current user is an admin or not. We end our code with a semicolon. Set user admin status. Now, how do we want to do this? Everyone's logic may be a little different, but what I like to do is I will set a variable and I'm going to call it isAdmin. And you'll see here, as I'm typing, IntelliSense is trying to help me. The smart IntelliSense is such a lifesaver. You'll notice that my variable also is camel case. Lowercase I is for is, uppercase A for admin. Whatever convention you find that works for you, stick with it. Don't make the first letter capital and the second letter capital or whatever. Try to be consistent. You'll find that over time, it just makes more sense to you. So now that we have the variable set, we want to look at our data set, the collection that we created, call at provers, and see if the current user is in there. So how we're gonna do that is count the rows if the user is in that data set and their status is set to active. So with that, we start with an if statement. So if, and we're gonna count the rows, and I can use the down arrow on my keyboard and then tab, off the filter statement, and we're going to filter our collection, call approvers, by var user, and we have var user and var user two, you could use either one at this point, dot email equals email. And you see I mistyped it, IntelliSense helped me for it. And we want to know if they're active or not. Because in our SharePoint list, it's a yes or no column, it's true or false. And so you just have to say active if it's active. We could also do if it's not active in that fashion. Okay, so end two parens, and you see as I'm ending them, it's highlighting, I pointed at my screen like you could see, it's highlighting the other one. So we know that we're outside of the filter statement. So now we're going to say if count rows is greater than zero, right? So if a user is in that collection and their set is active, what are we going to do? We're going to set this to true. If not, we're going to set it to false. Close our statement. Oh, and close the set statement. Now, if we right click on run on start, we're going to minimize this. If we click on our waffle or our hamburger menu and select visible, I can in here just type in is admin. And you see, I mistyped it, but IntelliSense helped me out here. So now, visible is just the value of is admin. And because we set it to true or false, it's true or false. Now, trust but verify. How are we going to test this? If we go back to my SharePoint list, I'm going to edit my record, and I'm going to change it to inactive or remove the checkbox. Now I go back to my data source. I'm going to go to data. I'm going to select the ellipsis here, refresh, and then go back to my app and rerun the OnStart, and you see the hamburger menu is gone. Most users won't have that experience because the app OnStart only runs when the OnStart happens once. But there we have it. If you found this tutorial helpful, please give it a thumbs up and leave a comment below. Let us know your thoughts, questions, and any topics you'd like us to cover in future videos. Sharing is caring, so don't forget to share this tutorial with your fellow Power Apps enthusiasts. Until next time, keep learning, keep exploring, and keep rocking Power Apps like a true pro. See you in the next video.